As I said, today my guest is the mayor of Lilongwe City, Dr. Desmond Williams Bikoko. Welcome to the program, Dr. Bikoko.
Thank you.
To start with, where were you born?
I was born in Queen Elizabeth Central Hospital in Blantyre.
Are you free to tell us how far back that was?
that is a secret kept closer to my heart. But I was gone many years ago.
Many years ago? Yes, somewhere in Blantyre.
Somewhere in Blantyre, yes.
How many are you in your family?
In our family, there are seven of us.
Okay.
I have three brothers
and
three sisters.
All right.
But I'm the only one currently in the country.
What happened to the others? Where are they?
We all grew up in Ethiopia.
I think really?
We left Malawi in 1988 to live in Ethiopia, where my father was working for the organization. At that time, it was Organization of African Unity.
Yes,
now
OAU.
OAU. Now it's African Union. So right from the from Ethiopia, we proceeded to the United States, where I attended all my education.
So where are the other six? Are they in Ethiopia or in America, or they're all over the world?
Actually, the whole family is in the United States, including my mother and my father. So I'm the only one who's back in Malawi.
Where did you spend your childhood as a young boy growing up?
Okay, as I grew up, before leaving Malawi, I spent my childhood in Area 15. So I have fond memories of Area 15, Area 47 area. And I went to school at Chigoneka, in primary school in Area 47, Sector Sector 2.
Okay. And then after that?
Then right after that, that's when we proceeded to Ethiopia in 1988.
How long did you stay in Ethiopia?
I was in Ethiopia for about 5 years.
Okay.
Yeah. So after I finished my I was here. I attended from my secondary school.
In Ethiopia?
In Ethiopia.
Wow. Anything interesting that you did in secondary school that you look back at and you're like, oh God, this was just something else?
Yes. Mm-hmm. I think during my secondary school, I was the fastest runner in my in our year.
You were the fastest runner.
I was the fastest runner in our. So actually, normally when we do the marathon in Ethiopia,
yeah,
I was always expected to be the top three. I was very good in Ethiopia.
Really?
So that's one thing I look back and say, wow, maybe I should have done. I should have done the.
Maybe you would have been the Usain Bolt of Malawi.
You know, you never know. But my life took a different path.
Yeah.
But when I look back, I think I enjoyed that. I also enjoyed the international flavor of Addis Ababa. You know, Addis Ababa is like the capital city of Africa.
Yes.
You get to meet people from different countries, all over Africa and also Europe, South America, North America. They're all in Addis Ababa.
They all meet there. It's a huge cosmopolitan city.
Yeah, so it's a melting pot for Africa.
And then from there, where did you go?
From there, I moved to a small state in the United States.
Okay.
I moved to Wyoming,
Wyoming.
The middle of a western country, United States. Yeah, that's where I spent about precisely about 4.5 years of my time.
Wow.
In doing my university level studies. Surprisingly, when I moved to the United States, I worked as a dishwasher in a McDonald's restaurant.
Oh,
McDonald's
really?
Fast food restaurant.
So you're working in McDonald's?
I did, yes. So
was that a full-time job or was it just something
to give
a few dollars?
Something to keep me, so put some money in my pocket. So I did that part-time, then I was also going to school full-time.
What was the experience working in McDonald's?
You know,
I think they're really busy restaurants in the U.S.
Yes, it was very busy. But you know, you've seen the movie Coming to America.
Yes, I have.
So, you know, the Prince of Zamunda.
Yes,
his first job was also at McDonald's. So I got excited and I took a picture, sent to my mother in Ethiopia. So,
I'm the Prince of Zamunda.
I'm the Prince of Zamunda, yes. So the experience was quite enriching for me, and I think I grew up as a man. I think I learned my work ethics during that period.
Okay.
Yeah.
After that, what happened? Where did you go?
After that, you know, I was young.
Yeah.
And excited that I was now in the United States.
Yes.
So I played around a little bit.
Yeah.
I didn't take education seriously.
Okay.
Until I realized that I think one day I woke up and said, you know what, I have to return home.
Yeah.
So I need to return home. An educated man, so I moved from where I was. I wanted to move away from all the spotlights into more an area where I would focus on my studies.
Okay.
So I moved to a bigger city and a bigger university in Denver, Colorado.
Okay.
Yeah. So actually, before that, I had also moved to Bellevue University in Nebraska.
Okay.
So that's when, at that particular time, I was now seriously taking my education at a serious level, trying to ensure that I get what I went to the United States for. Because I was on a student visa when I was going to the United States.
So where were your parents at this time?
They were in Ethiopia.
And when you were going to the US, mm-hmm. why did you go there? Who were you staying with?
I was staying at the university campus.
Okay.
Yeah, I
stayed. So you had gone there just as purely as a student?
Correct.
Just to do studies
Correct.
There? Okay. Mm-hmm. Interesting. Let's talk about music. Mm. Do you listen to music?
I listen to what kind of music?
Yeah.
But I love country music.
Ah, really?
Yes.
Fantastic. That's interesting. Mm. So what would be the first song today? Mm.
My first song today, I think in the country circles, would be Christian.
Christian.
And who I am with you. I love that track.
Is that a gospel tune or is that a love song?
It's more or less a love song, and I think I've dedicated that to my wife.
That's what I was gonna ask.
Because yes. it talks about the two of us.
Who I Am With You from Christian. That's the first choice from our guest today in Cruise 5. This is Cruise 5, and my guest today is Dr. Desmond Williams Bikoko. He is the mayor of the city of Lilongwe, which is the capital city of Malawi. But he spent a lot of time outside the country. As a matter of fact, he was in Ethiopia, spent a bit of time in America, and decided to come back. Tell me about coming back to Malawi. Mm. What had happened? I mean, you could have probably stayed in the US.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Actually, I was working and going to school in the United States.
Okay.
Actually, I had been also sponsored by my employer at that time to do my master and my PhD in the United States. Mm-hmm. And I had a chance to stay in the United States. But I think all along, I had a passion of coming back to Malawi. Even when I was in Ethiopia, people had nicknamed me Banda. So in my high school photos, you see, they used to call me Banda because
Which
I was
Banda?
Spoke Kamuzu Banda.
Kamuzu Banda.
Yes.
Yes. They called you Kamuzu Banda.
They called me Banda, in short, because I think I spoke about Malawi all the time. I had a passion for Malawi, coming back home to help the country develop. So I never lost touch with what was happening on the ground. And I knew that once I finished my studies, I would definitely come back home. So the minute my dissertation was approved, my PhD dissertation was approved, I also resigned and told my boss I want to go back. Before I left the United States, I even told my colleagues that I want to go to Malawi and one day become mayor of Lilongwe. So I was coming home to become mayor of Lilongwe. That was my dream.
You told people that you were coming to
Malawi? I told my best friends, I said, I'm going to run for the mayorship of Lilongwe.
You had this plan before you came to Malawi?
I had these plans before I came to Malawi.
Oh, that's astounding. That's astounding. And everything turned out to be what you wanted it to be. I wonder what else you're wishing for. We get to hear about that later. But about your studies,
yes.
What did you study?
At my undergraduate, I've done a BA degree in leadership from Bellevue University in Nebraska, United States. Okay. Then I also did an executive MBA and a project management MBA from Colorado Technical University in Colorado. And my PhD was in international business. So those are the degrees that I've done.
So, coming back to Malawi with a mission to be the mayor of Lilongwe City, which you are now, which I find absolutely amazing. Mm-hmm. How did you set about doing that? What was your game plan? How did you, because I don't think you were in politics that much before you came here.
Surprisingly, I was behind the scenes.
Okay.
I think when I came back, I had knocked on every door.
Okay.
My plan was to go into government, work for 5 years,
okay.
so I can understand the systems of government, then go into politics. But when I came back, I had applied for every job you can think of, and I was also turned down. The reason is I was too young and over-qualified. So because of that, I got frustrated.
That's bizarre. You're too young and overqualified. I thought that should work to your advantage.
Well, that's what I was told. I even removed my PhD for my my CV.
So that people can, when they say this is a PhD holder, they're like, no, we can't possibly hire a PhD holder.
Yeah. So out of frustration, then I decided just to get involved into maybe behind the scenes. I was helping some party gurus, maybe writing their manifestos, other research projects. So I worked for... Surprisingly, behind the scenes in the DPP office.
Oh, really?
In Area 10.
Okay.
With Honorable Wakuda Kamanga at that particular time. Yeah.
Yes.
So, because I had a passion to get into politics.
Okay.
Yeah. So, from there, I think I also helped a little bit of during the regime of Joyce Banda.
Yes.
I was also appointed as Deputy Secretary General of the Orange Partners. Even though it was short lived, because I didn't like the idea behind the position. So, I resigned quickly.
Okay.
Yeah. So, that has been my involvement into politics before running for
and then MCP.
Yes, interestingly, MCP.
How how did that happen? How did that transition happen from DPP to PP briefly and then MCP?
Okay, that time I wasn't a member of any political party.
Okay.
I was just helping out these people in the background. I had not fully subscribed to a party membership. But now when I was looking for councillorship, I was looking for which party would welcome me to run on their ticket.
Okay.
So MCP, where I was, I found some few people. They said, we have no councillors, but we're MCP group. Mm-hmm. Can you run on MCP ticket? Mm-hmm. So I concurred and ran on MCP ticket. Okay. as a councillor.
Why didn't you go for Member of Parliament, which I think is a bit more...
No, like I said earlier on, I wanted to be a mayor.
Okay.
So being a mayor, you need to run as a councillor. So I was very strategic.
So your eyes were on the mayorship?
Yes, I was.
Nothing else but the mayorship?
Nothing else. I was only interested in MPship. I wanted to be a mayor of the city.
Let's talk about music. Mm. What would be your next choice?
Next choice? I think slightly different.
Yes.
Would be Michael Jackson and the group. I think it's, He with the World.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh,
that's a very classic song.
Obviously, Michael Jackson is a huge, huge artist. So this is Heal the World from Michael Jackson. This is Cruise 5, and today we're at the Lilongwe City Council offices. I'm right in the office of the mayor of Lilongwe City. The mayor is Dr. Desmond Williams Bikoko. The man on a mission, the man who dreamt of being the mayor of Lilongwe City, and now he is the mayor of Lilongwe City. Set out to become mayor, finally achieved it. This must be the end for you, because this is what you set out to achieve. And you now you have achieved it.
Mm.
So after this, I mean, it's time to pack up and go and do something else.
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to reveal too much my plans for the future. But I think what I can say is I'm a very ambitious person.
Yes.
But I like to strategize. I don't like to jump into issues. I want to continue. I think I'm also interested in becoming a member of parliament.
Yes.
And I think, but people have to see what I'm able to do as a mayor. The position has its own challenges and it's also opportunities. So it's for me to, currently I'm focusing on being a mayor for the city. The rest will come in its own time.
Well, the elections are coming soon. So if you want to be MP, this is the time to start.
Correct.
So you're moving things in the background.
I am.
Yeah.
Yes.
Hoping to become an MP
yes.
of a certain constituency in Malawi at some point.
Correct. And I'll make my announcement in due course.
Tell me about becoming mayor.
Mm.
They are justifiable expectations because people say this is a young man full of brilliant ideas.
Mm-hmm.
He spent a lot of years outside the country, so he knows how things should be run.
Mm-hmm.
And when you were appointed mayor, when you won as mayor, as a matter of fact, people were like, this is it. And now, a year on, people are like,
9 months.
Is there, okay, close to a year really,
yes.
9 months, but close to a year on. People are like, what's the difference between this mayor and the one that was there before him?
Okay.
Because he was a fairly old man, to be fair, the one that you succeeded.
Okay.
And people thought that you're going to transform the city in no time.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about that.
Mm. You know, I think after winning the mayorship, I came out with a 10-point plan.
Yes.
And that is where... I am working on. I'm not looking at anything else outside the 10-point plan. And I think we have done quite a lot in the last 9 months. Out of the 10-point plan, I think we have achieved 6 of the 10-point plans. What we have done, because currently the Lilongwe City Council is into huge financial challenges, because of not because we have no money. The systems have collapsed. So we've been rebuilding the systems. Because when I came mayor, I think we had gone 5 years without being audited. As Lilongwe City Council, without our books being reconciled for the last 5 years. As I'm speaking to you right now, the audit for the last 5 years has now been fully completed.
Mm-hmm.
We are now going to the reconciliation. It has also has its own challenges. But in the midst of all that, we have been able to do certain things that I promised the residents of Lilongwe. You know, we have achieved, you know, some areas.
I can't see anything.
Well, I'm not sure what you can see.
No, I mean, like going in the streets of Lilongwe, the service delivery is pretty much, it's not there at all.
Then I think it's not fair that you can see anything. I think we have done quite a lot. It's a question of what have you not achieved on your 10-point
plan? What can you point at? What can you point at, Dr. Bikoko, the mayor of Lilongwe City? What is it that you can show that these are the fruits of the 10-point plan that we put in place?
Like I said earlier on, we had auditing of city council books. That has been fully done. Secondly, we're also looking at the issue of the Lumbazi sewer line, which was has been ongoing for the last 20 years, has been also done. You're also talking about the infrastructure, street lighting, Adopter Street, that has also been done.
I haven't seen any lights on the streets.
Well, the lights are on. I think challenges are now some of the our partners have not taken on board In some of the streets.
Because the main road that leads into the city, it's pitch dark at night. You can't see anything.
Which one is it?
People have talked about lights from Lumbadzi all the way to the main city, to the center of Lilongwe City. You don't have... There used to be lights in many parts of the city, going to Nchinji, going to Bwalolanjobu, going to city center. Driving at night, it's a nightmare. It's like you're driving into a dungeon.
Well, I think most of the streets that you can see right now, they have lights. I think the challenge is maybe... they have not had, I think, with the blackouts and other issues, we haven't had lights set. Some of them have some challenges that we have put a meter in, but it has also gone missing after being installed. So we have this challenge that I think we are still currently taking place.
Yeah, that's a bit frustrating.
It is frustrating, and I think we ought to blame for it. But like I said, I'm only looking for solutions. Now, if you go towards game complex, going to the new mall, Gateway Mall, that we have finished that phase. From Old Town into Bwalolanjobu, we have finished that phase. We talk about, I think, Kanengo, going towards the airport. You've seen there are some street lights being put. You talk about Kamuzu Central Hospital going away to Crossroad. That has also been fully done. All these streets in city center, they have also been done. But some of them don't have meters yet. You know, it's a process, but at least we have taken care of installing the poles and the street lights. We're just waiting for ESCOM to come and install the power on those streets.
So the lights haven't been switched on yet?
Some, yes, haven't been switched off. Some we have now gone, we have missing ESCOM meters. It was installed, but it has now gone missing.
When are we seeing street vendors off the streets? Tell me how challenging it is to get them off the streets. Why is it so hard?
Twofold. I think, firstly, we need to address the issue of where do we place the vendors. Secondly, even on our part, I think you're aware of the new bylaws that we passed a couple months ago. We're still waiting for the ministry to approve. When that is done, for me, I'm looking at enforcement. You can have the bylaws in place, but we need to have an ongoing team of enforcing officers. So we are looking at two different options, the Malawi Police Services, or secondly, engaging a private firm in conjunction with the Malawi Police Services to enforce our bylaws. Because we need to move them from the street permanently, not a one-off, a one-day exercise.
That's what happens. That's why I was saying, why is it so difficult? Because one minute you see them off the streets, and then they're back. Yes. And then they're off, and then they're back.
Correct.
That tells me that there's something that is not working there. Because efforts have been put into getting them off the streets, but in no time they're back.
That's why I'm going back to say we need to have our own enforcement team.
Do you have the legal... space to play around with that and get your own team to enforce the laws? Because I think as it is now, you are still stuck with the Malawi Police Service.
That's why we're looking for innovative ways of working with Malawi Police Services. First option is getting the Malawi Police Services as part of the Lilongwe City Council. A unit of becomes a city patrol team working with the Lilongwe City Council. We're looking to that through the Minister of Local Government. Second option is getting maybe a private firm to work with the Malawi Police Services. So we need to look at options that are available to us that are also they're also within the laws of Malawi. So that is a process that we are currently trying to experiment with. Because for me, I'm looking at having a team every Monday to Sunday on the ground enforcing the bylaws, not just against the vendors, but against all other sectors within the city of Lilongwe.
As a Lilongwe resident, I always ask myself, how close are we to seeing what happened in Blantyre happen in Lilongwe? If you go to Blantyre now, you can see physically the change that is there. The roundabouts are cleaner, the streets are cleaner, and the garbage collection, yeah, they're still working on it, but you can see, you can feel that there's a fresher look. How close are we to seeing something like that in the capital city of Malawi, Lilongwe? Because if you go to the streets now, if you go into the city now, you still see heaps and heaps of garbage uncollected.
Correct.
The drainage system is absolutely not there. It just needs to shower, and then all the streets are swamped with water. It's smelling in the city. How close are we to see? How close are we to seeing a beautiful city that we're going to be proud of?
I think without making any short-term promises.
Yes,
we are working. We are, I think the systems are being put in place. Because I think, for me, I know people don't want to see immediate results. But you know what? The challenge with immediate results, I can give you something good today, mm-hmm. but it's only short-lived. There has to be a system in place that even if beyond my tenure, mm-hmm. you know, it is functioning fully. Mm-hmm. Like I said alone, I think in the past, most systems within the Lilongwe Council were broken. Mm-hmm. So we've been busy putting systems in place without putting a blame on anybody mm-hmm. to ensure that they are effectively working internally. Mm-hmm. So they are being put in place. And I think sooner, it has taken longer, but sooner or later you'll be seeing results of what we have done as a council.
Still doesn't answer my question of how soon we are to seeing a clean
And system. I say that I can't give you specific dates because now I'll be over-promising. Mm-hmm. But I'm saying systems are in place. Are we putting systems in place?
So you're confident that at some point we're going to see a beautiful world-class city?
Yes. Mm-hmm. That's my short answer.
All right. We're going to get longer answers later, but for now, I want us to get into our third song. What would be your third choice?
Third choice would be Desperate by Faith Musa.
Desperate by Faith Musa. That's the third song for my guest today in Cruise 5.
Chini chansi chungwe ndili nacho Sacho kila kwa inu Ngakale nchito yungwe ndiku kwila Miami ka inu Shukulu yose yungwe ndafunzila Miami ka inu Ngakale magigala tiku imba Timaimbi la inu Ndili desperate for your love Dili desperate for your head Dili desperate for your touch Dili desperate Dili desperate for your love Dili desperate for your head Dili desperate for your touch Dili desperate Dili desperate Dili desperate Dili desperate Dili desperate
Trophy right behind you.
Yes.
When are people contesting for that trophy?
Soon.
Soon as in?
Very soon.
Because it had to be dusted off when we came here. It hasn't been contested for I can't remember when.
Like I said at the very beginning, when I came to office, what I had wanted to do immediately, reality was different. So I had to defer most of my program to ensure I take care of the immediate needs of Lilongwe City Council. So, but the Mayor's Trophy is coming up sooner, among other programs that are under the pipeline.
I was quite surprised when I heard the other time the tug of war between the City Council and the Minister of Lands fighting for a piece of land, and the question of who holds control over which pieces of land. I'm told you wanted to build an international bus terminal. Where exactly did you want this built?
This was going to be in a bypass area. Okay. We had been allocated by a piece of land adequate for an international bus terminal. But we have since lost it.
So you lost it?
We lost it. And I'm not amused by the loss of the international bus terminal, because we had an investor in place ready to construct an international bus terminal, and I met him personally.
The mother ministry was invited to mediate in this issue, and eventually they said, no, what is it? They don't want the bus terminal? Or?
No, we had actually, under the previous mayor, we had already signed an MOU with Kato Civil by of me, Mr. Simbi,
yes,
to construct an international bus terminal. Everything was in place. I had a copy of the MOUs when I came into office. The land was given to Lilongwe City Council. It was all set. So I had traveled to South Africa to meet the investor.
Yeah.
And he had given me his assurance that once we had sorted out our internal issues, he was ready to start constructing the national bus terminal. Now, when I came back from South Africa, first thing I did was inquire where we were as a council.
Yes.
In terms of taking ownership of that piece of land. Wanted to find out it had been sold to another third party.
Unbelievable.
Yes. So, and this third party has also sold it.
To another?
To a foreigner who now wants to build a hotel on the land that was initially allocated for international bus terminal.
What would be your next step?
Well, currently, we've lost ownership of that piece of land. Because mm-hmm. I think ideally what happens when we allocated a piece of land, we're supposed to take ownership, we ask for an offer letter, we pay Minister of Lands, then we now invite in the investors to pay us as a Lilongwe City Council. I think on our part, we were not proactive. So it took us longer to get processes started. Now, in the midst of that, I'm not sure what happened on the end of Minister of Lands. They offered it to somebody else, maybe who was ready to pay for the same piece of land. And he had also promised to build an international bus terminal, only to turn around and sell it to another person, a foreigner for that matter, for a hotel. And this foreigner has already paid the total value for that piece of land. So as the Lilongwe City Council, we don't have an international bus terminal. So we'll have to discuss again with Minister of Lands where there's another area where they can locate us for an international bus terminal.
And there's total chaos at the minibus terminal in the city. One, I don't know when that place is going to be developed to some semblance of a minibus terminal. The one where you've got most of the bulk of minibuses in the Lilongwe city. It's a pit. It's literally a pit. It's dusty, it's muddy when it rains. And then there's someone building a huge filling station right next to it, and there's a hospital next to it, and then you wonder, what is happening to my city?
You know, it's a shame that we're operating in that environment, but the challenges, I think there are three landlords within Lilongwe.
Three landlords?
We have Lilongwe City Council, Minister of Lands, and Malawi Housing. These three landlords, they have to be talking to each other.
Yes.
Okay, if Malawi Housing is giving a piece of land to a developer, they have to talk to Lilongwe City Council. Mm-hmm. And by the way, all approvals of development, they have to come to
the Lilongwe City Council.
City Council.
It's the one that holds the ultimate authority over the other.
Correct. Mm-hmm. But what you find out, I'll give an example of where people are building near Waila Hospital.
Yes.
They have no plans to construct, mm-hmm. put up any structures. Okay, we have gone to enforce our bylaws. People have taken us to court. Mm-hmm. There are court injunctions involved. Now, when the court injunctions involved, our hands are tight. Okay, there's nothing we can do until that injunction has been removed. We tried to remove it. They quickly went to Blanta, obtained another injunction. Against the Lilongwe injunction. Before the court was set to make a decision, they rushed to the Supreme Court. So the other challenge is, I think we tend to abuse the legal systems to put in illegal structures within the city. So in between, we have to wait for the outcome of the court decision. Because if we move before the outcome, the decision has been made, we seem to be in contempt of the court systems. That's why I think you see people are still able to develop even before the court injunctions have been vacated. But end of the day, all those injunctions will be vacated, because what we need in Lilongwe City Council are two things. Do you have ownership to the piece of land? Secondly, have your plans been approved by Lilongwe City Council? If the answer is no to both, nobody has the authority to put up any structures within the city.
But the structures are being put up.
And that's what I'm saying. They're doing that
outside. They will have to be demolished then.
And we can't demolish because there's an injunction against Lilongwe City Council. See, so it's a little bit of
it's a jigsaw puzzle.
Yes, yeah, I think
it's a jigsaw puzzle.
Yes, yeah. We would love to go in today and demolish and enforce the law. But now the court is saying, no, wait a minute. You can't do that because there's this injunction. And that challenge for me, with all due respect to the legal system, I think when lawyers and judges are making decisions to issue injunctions, I think sometimes you look at what makes common sense.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm not trying to attack the judiciary, mm-hmm. but I'm appealing to them that I think let's make common sense decisions. We are all residents of Lilongwe City. So decisions that we're making today will have impact on all of us that are residing in Lilongwe. And the same people that actually, you know, representing people that have taken injunctions to court.
Yes.
They're the ones also complaining about lack of development or substandard development.
That's preposterous.
The city. Yes.
That's preposterous.
So for me as a mayor, honestly, I think I find it very, you know, it's sort of amusing,
mm-hmm.
but I think sometimes it's about, maybe it's about money.
Mm-hmm.
But how much money can I make from...
From this piece of
yes.
land. Yeah, yeah. You must be frustrated.
Very.
But at the end of the day,
we have to move on. And
are there times when you say, I think I should just resign as mayor and go back to my peaceful life as...
No. You know, this is my dream job. You know, with these challenges, I'm enjoying the job.
But you never anticipated all this. So, I mean, there are times when you say, maybe it was a bad dream. Maybe it was a bad choice. Maybe I should just...
You know, as when you move into a leadership position,
mm-hmm.
you expect to meet all sorts of challenges. Okay, so I knew that there would be challenges. I knew there would be opportunities. I knew I'd be criticized. But at the end of the day, I have to focus on the task at hand, which is getting the Lilongwe City where it ought to be.
That's going to be a challenge because I hear you're not in good talking terms with your colleague next door, the chief executive officer of Lilongwe City Council.
That is incorrect.
It's incorrect.
We have a new acting CEO.
Mm-hmm.
I think the issue that happened were internal.
Okay.
And we have a new acting CEO.
Okay.
And we meet twice a week.
Mm-hmm.
He comes to my office for briefing. We're able to set the pace, the agenda for the city together. Where I'm making mistakes, he's mm-hmm. able to correct me, say no, take different directions.
Mm-hmm.
Where I was not seeing things moving, I'm also able to tell him that I think we need to go towards the direction. So our relationship is very good. The two offices have to be able to talk and get along with each other.
Well, in principle, they're supposed to. Doesn't mean that that's what's happening, probably.
Currently, it is happening. With
yeah.
the current CEO.
So there's a mutual working relationship between you and the CEO of the Lilongwe City Council.
I think my role as a mayor mm-hmm. is provide leadership
yeah.
at the council.
Political leadership.
Political leadership.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the CEO is a controlling officer,
mm-hmm.
and he's also supposed to provide technical advice to my office
mm-hmm.
to ensure that we are doing what we're supposed to be doing as a council.
Mm-hmm.
So currently, with a new CEO, we're able to do that. We're able to develop a good working relationship and move the city forward. And I think since he's come on board, I have been encouraged by the ability of the two officers to get along together and be able to move Lilongwe forward. But mind you, we need to agree to disagree.
Mm-hmm.
Where I'm wrong,
mm-hmm.
he should quickly move in and correct me without taking offense.
Yeah.
Where he's wrong, I should also be able to direct him in the direction. But whenever you disagree with a decision, offer an alternative.
Mm-hmm.
Don't just disagree
for the sake of it
without offering an alternative.
Your fourth song, the mayor of Lilongwe City, what would be your fourth choice?
Reggae, Bob Marley, Buffalo
oh, yes.
Soldier.
Every young man in Malawi grew up listening to reggae. Did you
correct.
Listen to a lot of reggae?
I sure did. I think that's what I knew back in the days, just reggae alone.
That's how most people got introduced to music. I heard guys say, you'd first know reggae, and then you know the other genres
yes.
of music.
Yes, and I think every Malawian, back in the days, would listen to reggae. There was Bob Marley.
Yes.
There was Peter Tosh.
Peter Tosh, yes.
We had all these...
Kacha. Banewela.
But yeah.
Yeah.
The good old days.
All those good old days. And Bob Marley. Now I see why you were failing to choose between Michael Jackson, because I didn't know you were going to choose
yes.
Bob Marley. So, Bob Marley, what's going to be the song?
Buffalo Soldier.
Soldier. Oh, the iconic Buffalo Soldier from Bob Marley.
Buffalo Soldier, dreadlock rasta. It was a Buffalo Soldier in the heart of America, stolen from Africa. From, then you wouldn't have to ask me.
This is Cruise 5, and my guest today is His Worship, the Mayor of Lilongwe City, Dr. Desmond Williams Bikoko. Apart from being the Mayor of Lilongwe City, what else do you do? Do you have a company? Do you run some businesses?
Yes, I run a company called Madison Holdings.
Tell me more about it.
Madison Holdings is a baby that I founded after being frustrated from finding a job.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm into trainings,
okay.
Consultancies. I also have the university, Riverton University.
Oh, really?
In Lilongwe.
Ah.
I'm also into catering.
Mm-hmm.
I also have a car tracking company. Within it.
That's a lot of stuff.
Yes, and then out of that, I'm also what's other unit that I have?
Mm.
We do management of outsourcing of businesses. So I also do recruitment for other firms.
Sounds like a
so
big.
So that's what I do.
It's a big company.
No, we are very small.
Mm-hmm.
We are very small.
You're able to manage all those things with a small team.
Well, not a small team, but
yeah.
What I've done, I've employed people
okay.
on a full-time basis
all
that
right.
I think currently they run the businesses on my behalf.
Of course, that was going to be...
later,
yeah.
We're also planning... Actually, we're in the process of going into real estate.
Ah.
Yeah, that's where we are thinking the future of the business should be.
I heard about the Keep Lilongwe City Green campaign.
Mm-hmm.
What progress are you making on that?
It's 6 months behind
okay.
schedule. As you're coming in last week, we wrote some letters, some proposals, which we want to follow up this week. We want to bring in residents, as well as businesses, into the campaign. So what I'm looking at is once a month, we have come up with a name, Ukondo Day. So
oh.
once a month, every resident will have to come out and do their role in getting the city cleaned.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so I'm also trying to talk to businesses to ensure that if you go, example, I'll give an example,
mm-hmm.
Maula area.
Yes.
Okay, that area is, I pass through it every day.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty dirty.
Mm-hmm.
The landscape is poorly
mm-hmm.
done.
Done. Mm-hmm.
I want to encourage the businesses to ensure that maybe within their premises, they're able to take care of the landscape,
mm-hmm.
keep it green.
Mm-hmm.
It don't cost them a lot of money.
Yeah.
Now, as a role for the City Council is to ensure that we're not collecting
mm-hmm.
garbage
mm-hmm.
and keeping the surroundings very clean. So my role is to ensure that everybody in Lilongwe gets involved.
What response are you getting from these companies? Because it's quite dumbfounding to see how a businessman or a whole business is failing to maintain their front yard. It's a small patch that they have to look after, but they can't even fix it. And you're trying to get them to do all these things. I don't know if they'll be willing to do that.
Yeah, I've talked to some.
Mm-hmm.
I started this last week when I was coming up with ideas. Some are eager. We just have to have formal signing ceremonies.
Mm-hmm.
Today, right after this meeting, I'm also meeting in the mayor's community ambassadors.
Okay.
We have appointed about 6 ambassadors who are now these community leaders, local media leaders. I've also included in the Nigerian community,
mm-hmm.
Rwandese community,
ah.
the Chinese community,
mm-hmm.
to bring them on board. So when we're making decisions as a council, they have to be part and parcel. We need to hear from them so they can also hear from us. Now, in terms of getting businesses to clean up their premises,
surroundings, yes.
I think, for the most part, yeah. With all due respect, we wait for the authorities to take care of us. Okay, there is never a partnership like coming in from the private sector. Very mm-hmm. few have come to us. I'll give an example: Standard Bank has come to us.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the banking sector have come to
mm-hmm.
us, but I think council has not reached out to the business communities.
Community.
They have also not found an opening to come and talk to us. So I'm saying, as a mayor, I want to go to them. I'm reaching out to them and say, can we now talk? How best do we work together?
Mm-hmm.
With example, ShopRite
mm-hmm.
and Pacific Mall on the other side, opposite
mm-hmm.
ShopRite. You've mm-hmm. seen a bunch of minibuses parking. They are nuisance to traffic.
Exactly.
That area is not meant for minibus.
It's not a minibus terminal.
Terminal.
Mm-hmm.
But all these years, they've been able to park and
mm-hmm.
cause havoc within the city.
Mm-hmm.
I approach ShopRite.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to come up with a way of getting those minibuses removed
mm-hmm.
without creating
tension.
Further havoc
mm-hmm.
to the city. So we have to also talk to the minibus association
mm-hmm.
and find a way, say, no, let's bring sanity within the city without provoking anybody. But it takes the leadership to talk to the community if where they're not forthcoming. So I'm starting now I should have done this 6 months ago, but I think there were other issues that I was dealing with. So it's better now than never at all.
As we are winding up, I've got a set of questions that I'd like to ask you, and I would want you to answer by just saying yes or no. Are you ready to play the game with me?
Go ahead.
Cruise questions with Dr. Desmond Williams Bikoko. My first question is going to be, do you have any tattoos?
No, I don't.
Do you have any piercings?
No.
Do you ever want to be president of Malawi?
Yes.
Do you have children?
Yes, I do.
Have you ever shot a gun?
Yes.
Have you ever cried over someone?
Yes.
Have you fallen in love before?
Definitely, yes.
Have you killed a chicken before?
Yes.
Have you gotten into a fight before?
Definitely, yes.
Have you gotten any surgeries before?
Yes.
Have you ever been hospitalized?
Yes.
Have you donated blood?
Yes.
Have you smoked weed?
No.
Would you smoke weed?
No.
Have you drunk alcohol?
Definitely, yes.
Have you broken someone's heart?
I believe so.
Have you had a crush on someone?
Yeah, of course, yes.
This is the end of the cruise questions. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.
You're welcome.
Your last choice.
Yeah. My last choice would be Danilu.
Danilu.
Sweet banana.
So it's going to be Danilu, yeah. Sweet banana. That's the last choice from my guest today in Cruise 5, Dr. Desmond Williams Bikoko, the mayor of Lilongwe City. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Yes.